Our gracious Lord and Father, we thank you for this morning. We thank you for another opportunity to gather here and build ourselves up and network as project managers. We pray that whatever we've planned to do here today, you will be in our presence and guide us to have a successful meeting. In Jesus' mighty name have I prayed. Amen.
Okay, so does anybody want to share how you guys formed your teams and experiences? I saw some teams trying to dial me into some of your sessions. I got a lot of calls. I was like, no, I'm not part of it. Let me just stay out. There was one that I took and I said, okay, my name is this. I'm not supposed to be here, so can I log out? And they're trying to ask me questions. Do you want to share any experience? Okay. Why? You don't want to share? Why do you say you should not share? Please go ahead.
Thank you. Good morning. My name is Ni, and I'm in team determination. We are still forming the group. I'm sure that's the more reason she doesn't want me to share, but we are still forming, and it's been terrible. I'm sure some of the team members will attest to this. You put something on the page and then it will take for like 2-3 days before somebody will say, at least a word. Some will even give you this. So to us, we are still forming. Fortunately.
Thank you very much. I saw you have a presentation. So if you are still forming and have a presentation, I wonder how you guys did it. All right, cool. Before I get into my slides, I would just like all of us to get to know each other. So we'll do a quick introduction. And basically, you tell us your name, possibly where you work, and then, you know, just one or two things about why you joined PMI Ghana chapter. Okay? Very brief before we get into the slides. All right? I'll skip this gentleman. I'll come back to him later. So please, I'll start with you.
Good morning. My name is Evelyn Toto. I work for Evandi Estate Limited. I work for Evandi Estate Limited, and I joined the PMI to network and volunteer. Thank you.
Hello. Michael Otuwuda. I work with Aqua Safari Resort. I joined the PMI Ghana. Okay, I'm Michael Otuwuda. I work with Aqua Safari Resort. Yeah, I joined the PMI Ghana for networking and mentorship opportunities. Yes.
I'm Ato Sam. I work with JP Can Associate, and I joined for networking and for learning as well.
I'm Daniel Uchebu.
I'm Daniel Uchebu. I'm a group of business administration firm. I joined PMI, to assist in network and also gain more knowledge on actual different things. Because actually,
before I was working with Talu during geology, and I got an interest in the socioeconomic project, which was building more sort of construction work. Then I deferred into their part of it. That's my main reason for joining PMI, just to learn management, project management, and build myself my career.
Did you get
the
site for the team?
No.
My name is Dorothy Okayashi. I work with Fidelity Bank Ghana, East Legon branch. I joined to network, basically.
My name is Gabriel Lamte, work with Abbey National. I'm joining to stay updated on industry trends and also to network as well.
All right, my name is Justice Bading. I work with Total Energies Marketing Ghana PLC, and I'm with PMI for professional networking and development as well.
Good morning once again. My name is Nikwe Daniel. I'm with Ghana Maritime Authority, and I'm joining the PMI for the fun of it, you know, the networking and then all the good things that it has. Thank you. Exactly.
Good morning. My name is Ajoecha Ebredakwa. I work with Prudential Bank. I'm in the Central Processing Unit. And then I joined for professional growth and networking. Let's
go this side. My name is Florence Badon. I work with the National Lottery Authority. So I joined to gain insights into the whole idea of PMI, what it's about, project management is about, because I work in a public institution and project management is not something we use or practice. So the idea is to gain some knowledge that I can transfer to my business. Thank you.
Are you a one-woman team? I don't see your colleagues here. So, no, we've had one-man team before. We've had one-man team before, so I'm not surprised. So hopefully your colleagues will join you. All right.
Great. Thank you. Please, my name is Isaac Ajuman. I'm a professional engineer, and I specialize in project planning and controlling. I also do insurance risk assessment, project cost, and project management. I actually joined PMI for one or two reasons, basically to improve on my skills, two, to also build network with other like-minded colleagues, and also gain access to most of PMI materials. Yeah, so basically that is it. Thank you.
Okay, so I'm Frida McCarthy. I'm a project lead at Fromty Limited. I joined PMI to network for continuous learning and also to access PMI's resources.
Yeah. So good morning. I'm Anne-Marie Afeni-Godwell. I'm a public health consultant with KPMG Kenya Bagana office. I'm based here in Ghana with all of you. So I've been in project management, also public health related, for the past 10 years. And I just felt that it was about time to make it more professional for the CV. And I joined the chapter because I wasn't part of any professional network. So I felt that that's the right opportunity. Got the PMP done and then added it to my name. So my main role or my main title is public health monitoring and evaluation, project management. So my main role at KPMG is more of programmatic. So I just felt that being part of this group will just validate what I say I am. All right, thank you.
Good morning, I'm Belinda Kuli with MultiChoice Ghana. I joined for professional growth and networking.
Good morning, I'm Godwin Junior Gwevem. I work with Seek Focus Ghana Limited. It's a consultancy firm in anything construction. I actually joined PMI to network and as well develop my skills. Like the gentleman said, I know nothing about construction, but then I joined the firm and my boss happens to be a project manager, PMP, and to grab the skills and all that, I feel the best thing to do is to be a part of this body. Thank you.
Do I need to introduce myself?
Hello. I'm Joseph Tevi Hagin. My background is construction engineering. I work for Trade Aluminium Company. And I joined for professional development and networking.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Edna Amatekai Magnus. I work with 2C UFI Communications. It's a telecommunications company. 2C UFI Communications. UFI. 2C Unified Communications. Yes. And I joined PMI for networking and professional development. Thank you.
Yeah. So my name is George Apia Mpofu. I work with Asavia Engineering Limited, a road construction company. And I basically joined to network and then learn and growth and development, basically.
Hi, please, I'm Jennifer Apo. I work with First Atlantic Bank and I joined PMI for mentorship and professional growth. Yes.
Good morning. I'm Collins Kwekukuli. I work with Every Knee Company Limited, a construction firm. I'm also an entrepreneur. I joined PMI for professional development and networking. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. So I'm Faith Makafuido, and I'm a securities custodian with First National Bank. I joined PMI to grow in the project management profession, get to know more about it, and then collaborate with those who are making it within the industry so that I can also grow. Yeah.
All right, we see some newcomers. They are trying to catch their breath, but we'll catch them before they catch their breath.
There's one here. Yeah. Okay, so my name is Kwaku Boafo. I work as a mechanical engineer, building services. Yeah, so I joined PMI to be able to get to meet like-minded people, you know, and also to be able to connect advance in project management. Yes, so that's it.
Hello. Yourself, what you do, why you don't.
My name is Naomi, and I work for myself. It's called Versatile. We're into project property and event management. I joined PMI because I want to know more about project management.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Kweku Atta from Point Yeboa. I'm with Baobab Ghana.
Can you speak up? Can you hear you?
Okay. I'm Kweku Atta from Point Yeboa. I'm with Baobab Ghana. It's a telecommunication company. We're formerly known as MTN Global Connect Solutions Limited. I'm also a part-time farmer. So I joined PMI Ghana to network and to develop more in project management. Thank you.
Thank you very much, everyone, for that lovely introduction. We will move on with the rest of the activities. We've been joined by some volunteers, and we'll do a quick introduction before we get into the slides. So, Derek, I'll start with you.
Okay, so like Jalilu said, my name is Derek Asai Okufu. I work with Legna Group, Legna Construction Works. I'm a project manager by profession. Why I joined PMI about, how many years has it been? Maybe 3 or 4 years. Was because I, just like you, I wanted to network, develop as a project management professional, and then enjoy some group quality group. You know, the synergy within group, what you get from groups. I wanted to enjoy that also. So that's the main. And then I ended up as a volunteer for the membership portfolio. I'm the director of operations. So that's me. There's one other volunteer. I think I saw Frank.
Yes, so as I indicated earlier on,
we have our colleagues from the Toastmasters Club who are going to assess your presentation based on the chosen criteria that we gave you and to be able to adjudge which one came top and all that. So I'll let them introduce themselves and then I'll hand over to Frank to give us the welcome address.
Hello, good morning. My name is Anthony Eli Agbenu, or just call me Eli. I work at Enterprise Insurance. I'm the head of quality assurance there. And I joined PMI to network and to learn. And it would be wonderful for us to network during the course of the today.
Good morning. I'm Samuel Ayim. I'm not a project manager. I'm a lawyer, a leadership coach, and a trainer. I'm a member of Toastmasters, and I'm here to support, and I think we'll talk about Toastmasters a bit more later. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. A round of applause to everybody. Thank you. So let's welcome Mr. Frank Ato-Ou, who is going to give us a quick welcome address before we get into the various presentations. Mr. Frank Ato is a VP for Outreach. He's also a board member, PMI Ghana chapter.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. Welcome to all of you. I welcome all of you. I see beautiful faces and handsome gentlemen here. 4 years ago, I remember sitting in an environment like this with very beautiful people. I represented growth and we won. So you have your chief supporter here. Please, I don't want you to fail me today. I can see, I think only one person there. Oh, Asimu. All right, so it's a very privilege from PMI Ghana to have all of you here today. We are indeed delighted to have you. I would want to use this opportunity to encourage all of you to take today's session quite serious. Make time to understand, ask a lot of questions you would want to get clarity on. Myself, Jalilu, and other board members and other volunteers are going to be available here to assist you. Have fun. There's a lot of wache to eat. There's nine tea to enjoy. And as much as possible, do well to network. Make sure at least you leave here with about five people within your social community. The first time I came for the Akwaaba event, I ended up having quite some friends. Until today, these guys have led me on to some other places. One lady opened a door for me recently, and I mean a business door. Yes, so please do well to have fun and then enjoy the session. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Frank Ato. Okay, cool. Thank you very much. So, Derek will help me with the slides. I just want us to look at some of the things that we do from a PMI Ghana chapter perspective. Like I said, some of the things you already know, but it's important that we just emphasize on some of these things as well. Okay. So today, I'm just going to be taking us through a few items. Derek, if you can move the slides for me. Okay. So basically, what is PMI? We'll talk briefly about that. The Ghana chapter, you know, as part of PMI Global, the membership that we have, the various volunteering opportunities, and then you see some lovely pictures from our gallery as well. We do a lot of activities, and so we just want to show you some of the things that we do. They say that a picture speaks what louder than, it's better than 1,000 words, right? All right, so you see some of the things that we do. And I'm going to stick to the time. I have my team from, you know, Toastmasters here. They'll be timing me and they'll be raising the green, red, and yellow stuff. Okay, so next slide. Basically, the PMI Ghana chapter was founded in 2011 as a not-for-profit membership association. The global body is in the US, as you know already, and we have chapters dotted across the continent. And PMI Ghana chapter is one of the chapters. Our core purpose is to advance the practice, the science, and profession of PM in a conscious and proactive manner. And our value proposition is to be the eminent influence for the advancement and success of PM in all markets across the world. For our brand, we are saying that we're making project management indispensable for any business operation. You know, so for anything that you want to do, you have to plan, you have to have a schedule, you have to have some timelines, you have to have dependencies, and you have to have some outcome you want to achieve. Those are basically what forms project management. We want to make it indispensable for any operations that you want to embark on. And for our vision, we are saying that nationwide, across the country, we want all organizations to embrace the discipline. And when they achieve success, they attribute their success to the fact that they applied project management principles. So that's our vision. Okay. If you go to the site, you find all these details there. I don't need to go into the details. There are certain strategic objectives. One, we want to broaden our reach, extend our impact to the various communities that we serve, and then also build lasting relationships. With regards to the text that go with them, we'll make the slides available, and then you can read them for yourself. But basically, what we are saying is that you can't make an impact when people don't understand what you want to do. So broaden your reach and then make sure that people understand the principles of PM and engage with them to be able to apply it. You know, in a community where you are the only person who knows something, you can't make a lot of impact if others are not following you. We say that we have leaders because they are followers. And so it's important that you broaden your reach and ensure people understand what you want to do so that you can be effective. Extending our impact, I'll show you some of the things that we have done in the past. You know, volunteering and some of the outreach activities. And the tangible impact is had on some of the communities that we have reached out to. So that's exactly what we are talking about here. And the last one is building lasting relationships. Just like we have met here. There were times when, you know, in one of the Akwaaba events, one person got up and said, look, in my company, we have vacancies, about 3 or 4. And through that, you know, engagement, there were members who were not employed and they got jobs. You know, so it's important that, as Frank said, network, build relationships, and then try to get to know each other. You never know when you need to go to Aqua Safari and then somebody will be there to sort of sort you out, maybe with a discount or something like that. So basically, those are some of the strategic objectives. What we do, we develop our profession. So we have a whole list of activities that helps us to be able to develop as professionals through the various activities, and you see some of them as well. The chapter meetings, the webinars, the conferences, and all that helps us to be able to develop ourselves professionally. Okay? We network, just like we are doing now. At the end of the day, go home with people that you didn't have in your contacts book, at least 5 or 10, and begin to build that network with people, you know, that can make you progress in terms of your career, personal and professional development. We volunteer to give back to society. So PMI has over 10,000 volunteers, right? And all of us here, myself, Derek, Frank, Ato, are all volunteers. We are not paid. We just have the passion to want to serve. And there's a lot of things that goes on behind the scenes to ensure that some of the programs that you attend or some of the webinars happen. You know, the chapter meetings, the National Project Management Conference, and all that are all run by volunteers who are not paid. So we just have the passion to want to serve. That's the reason why we do what we do. Okay? We promote and advance the project management profession. We uphold, guard, and abide by the ethics of the profession. So just like any organization, you have an HR handbook or you have guiding policies or whatever. For PMI Ghana, we also have our bylaws, which we need to sort of protect. So these are some of the things that we do from a PMI Ghana perspective. You can skip this one. This just talks about the fact that it's a global institution, you know, with headquarters in the US, and it has a lot of members that have subscribed to it. So we have close to 700,000 global membership, over 306 chapters across 80 countries. We have more than 2.9 million professionals in 214 countries. And currently there are over 1.4 million PMP certified, you know, members across the globe. right? And as I said, we have over 10,000 volunteers. And again, all the chapters are run by volunteers. Nobody's paid. So I know you might have heard that we are trying to register a professional body. We've done that already, you know, so there might be some changes at the top to allow the chapter to run smoothly. That might involve a bit of employing people that we can pay, but there's just going to be a few people, not a lot. The bulk of the work will still be done by volunteers who are not paid. Okay? So basically, that is it. From a Ghana perspective, we are part of the Europe, Middle East, and Africa region. So as you can see, there are a number of PMI regions that cut across the globe. And we are part of the EMEA region. Okay, so for Ghana, in terms of our membership, as at August ending, we had about 1,633 members across. And these members don't just reside in Ghana. They are members who are in about 21 different countries aside Ghana. And they are all members of PMI Ghana chapter. Okay, some are in the US, the Canada, South Africa, Burkina Faso, Cote d'Ivoire, and all that. They are members of PMI Ghana chapter, but don't reside in Ghana. They all form part of the 1,633. Certified members, over 1,000 within the community, PMP alone. The other certified, certificates, like the ACP and all that, we've not even gone there. But PMP alone, over 1,000 out of the membership that we have in Ghana. And we have some non-certified members as well. We are the second largest in Africa in terms of number. I think Nigeria is number one. You know, we are trying very hard to beat them. They have some issues there. So we want to take advantage of the issues, grow our membership, and become number one. Hopefully, we'll do that before they sort out their issues. You know, so yes, that's how we are. In terms of the distribution by professional industry, the membership cuts across. There are people in the civil service. I mean, just like you introduce yourselves, a lot of people from different areas who are members. Now you see not applicable being the highest. It is because when people are registering, sometimes because of the work they do, they don't find, there's a drop down. They don't find anywhere that they belong. The only option is to choose not applicable. We're trying to see if we can work with PMI Global to sort of create room for people to add what they do. Because there are a lot of people who do work within some of these areas, but you don't find them. You only see not applicable, you know. But basically, that's a challenge with the system that we try to talk to Global to see how we can address. But it's just to give you an idea in terms of the broad range of industries where our members come from. I've spoken a bit about this already. So the value that we want to give, if you can just go back one. Yeah. Next one. Okay, so I've spoken about the fact that we build professional network, we expand our contacts, we gain skills and experience, and then we also develop as leaders. So we have vacant volunteering positions, and some of these things will build your leadership competencies, okay? You are given the opportunity to do a presentation, to lead a team, to impact on the community, or to implement a project. And those are things that build your leadership capabilities. So these are things that we do to make sure that members who join have value for what they subscribe to. Okay? Right. From a reach perspective, currently we are in 5 different regions. We have a branch in Tamale, there's a branch in Kumasi, Takrade, Sunyani, and Ho. So we chose some of these areas because we realized that some of our members are heavily concentrated there. You know, so don't ask me why we don't have a branch in Upper East or there are just a few. So Tamale can serve them as an example. You understand? So we look at how the members are sort of located and then we try to form their branches accordingly. You know, so that's how we have these branches currently working. Okay, next slide. As far as our governance is concerned, we have a governance structure that helps us to be able to govern the activities that we do. So there's an advisory council, there's a board, and then we have volunteers. But more importantly, there's a bylaw that governs everything that we do. you can't, if you're a member, you can't, you know, go outside of what members are expected to do. You know, so it's important that you always try to stick by it. When you join, I'm sure you got an email with the bylaw attached. If not, we can still share it as well. We used to send it on WhatsApp. I don't know whether when you got your welcome email, it was part of it. If it wasn't, we can still share those bylaws with you so that you can have it handy and then look at it. So currently, this is the structure of the board. There's a president. We have the VP membership. There's VP finance. There's VP for outreach. We have a secretary. There's VP for events. We have a VP for sponsorship. There's VP for professional development, and then VP for volunteering. So the president role is what you know. He's the president, and he's the chief servant of everybody. The VP membership looks after everything that has to do with the membership activities. So your registration, when your membership is expiring, and all those things. We celebrate birthdays, we celebrate certifications and all that. All activities that fall under membership. We are also responsible for recruiting new members and ensuring that you have value for your membership. So activities that we have to put in place to ensure you are constantly engaged is part of the work that the membership team does. Then we have the VP for finance, basically responsible for ensuring that we are strong financially. You know, some of the events are paid. And so VP finance is responsible for ensuring that we have money to be able to do all those activities. He's also responsible for ensuring we check, you know, which members sort of have not paid their dues and all those things. And then we sort of go after them. There's a system that we have that tells us everything about our financials, whether we are healthy or we are sick or we are in coma. The system will tell us financially. Then we have VP for outreach. Frank was here. He's responsible for ensuring that everything that goes out there to the media, everything that goes out there to social media and the publicity around the activities is responsible for that. Things on Facebook, on X, and all those things are handled by the outreach team. They do a lot more than that, but these are some of the things that I can just speak to off my head. We have a secretary who looks after all our activities and put things together in our various meetings and post the minutes and actions so that all the VPs can be able to do their work as well. Then there's VP for events. So this is an event we are having. So ideally, it falls under the event portfolio to ensure that logistics are in place, venue has been booked, the food you're going to eat, everything is paid for and all that. Everything that's got to do with events, whether it's a chapter meeting or a national project management conference, the VP event and the team are responsible for putting together the entire show. Okay? And they are all volunteers. They are not paid. We have VP for sponsorship, who would go out there to talk to companies and organizations to sponsor some of our events that we do. And then VP for professional development basically does the upload of your PDUs, you know. So at the end of the day, you earn PDUs for this session. The system is not automatic. It is done by people behind the scenes. So the VP for professional development and the team are responsible for ensuring that you get your PDUs and also other, you know, career enhancing activities like the webinars that you attend on a monthly basis and all that are put together by the VP for professional development. Then we have VP for volunteering. So he's basically the HR, you know, for the volunteers. So when there's a vacant position, VP for volunteering is responsible for recruitment, you know, to attract the right people to fill those vacancies. Currently, we have appointed a head of volunteering. He's not a VP. And I explain the difference. Usually, VPs are elected, okay? And for the board position, it can either be an elect through election or through appointment. The current VP for volunteering was appointed. You know, so we don't call him VP for volunteering. We say head of volunteering. So that's the difference. If you're elected, you're a VP. If you're appointed, you are a head. But I think the structure would change significantly with the professional body that we have formed. And I'm sure when President comes in, he would explain some of those things as well. Currently, the secretary position is vacant. The VP Finance is vacant. VP Event is also vacant. So if you are interested, you can see any of the board members. We have a process that you have to go through. You apply, you go through an interview process, and then when you're successful, you can become part of the board. So that's the structure as at now. Next slide. As I explained, the board positions are either via election or appointment, and there are other volunteering positions as well. So aside the VPs, under each of the portfolios, there are members. So in my portfolio, VP for membership, I have a director of operations, director for new membership, director for student affairs, director for a lot of things, you know. So some of the emails that you get wouldn't come from me. It will come from some of my team members as well. And everybody has a role that they play. So those positions, we don't go through election. We advertise that people apply, they go through a process, we interview them, and when they're successful, we give the roles to them. So that's the difference between the board positions and then other volunteering positions. We have some recommended clubs that we would like you to consider joining. The first one is the book club. I'm sure some of you are already, you know, logging on or dialing into the sessions. It happens, I think, on Tuesdays, 7:30. Yeah, so we usually pick a book, we share it amongst the team, you read, and then you come and discuss the things that, you know, are beneficial to all of us. I can be reading, you'll be reading, but my focus and what I pick up might be different from what you pick up. But when we come together to share ideas, we can broaden our horizon as a team. So we recommend that you join some of these clubs, you know, to also enhance your development. And then we have the Toastmasters Club. That one, I'll leave it because I have them here. I'll let Ellie speak a bit about Toastmasters Club later on when they do the assessment. And they can understand what they do, how to join, and all that. We'll give them the opportunity to speak about that. But it's basically a platform that allows you to develop your leadership and public speaking competencies, okay? And it's more than that, but I'll leave that to the expert. I don't want him to raise the flag right now, so I'll move on. Next slide. Okay, so for the volunteering position, you can either contact the VP, the head of volunteering, or visit our site. You see all the vacant roles, and if you want to apply, you can go ahead and apply as well. In terms of some of the activities, I can't run through all this, but we have our monthly chapter meetings, which happens the last Friday of every month, usually at Alisa. Okay. We have the branch meetings for all the branches I mentioned. So for Kumasi, Takrade, Tamale, Hoe, and Sunyani, they host us to a guest speaker series where they invite professionals to speak on diverse topics around project management. The last one we had was from the Takrade branch. The next one we're going to have will be the Tamale branch hosting all of us, and then followed by Ho and all that. So these are meetings that you should watch out for. On our WhatsApp platforms and other media, social media platform, you see all these things being advertised. Okay. So on a monthly basis, we try to keep members engaged, inform them about some of the things that are happening from the industry. And these branch meetings would help us to be able to, you know, communicate that accordingly. We also have a lot of updates that we send to members via email and via WhatsApp. Please, it is your responsibility to look at your emails, read, and respond accordingly. Some of the items are just for informational purposes. Some will require you to take certain action. So read the emails, read the WhatsApp messages, and act accordingly. You know, it is part of your duty as a member, you know, so that you can keep yourself active and all that. There are people who have missed a lot of important information because they simply did not care to open their emails or read the messages that we put on the WhatsApp platforms. So please do well to do those ones. I've spoken about the book club, which happens on a weekly basis. We also have the PMI Africa and Global Conference series. It's a yearly event, you know, on yearly basis. If you look at the structure, the regions, there are conferences that happens across. So for Africa, there's one that happens every year. And for the global, there's one that happens every year in the US. and they keep rotating the states. You know, last year it was Atlanta. This year they went to LA. Where's our VP for? He just came back. The ice is still on him, fresh. He just came back from LA. So every year they rotate the states. And, you know, you just have to watch out. Like I said, it will come through your email. They will send notifications and all that. And you have to go through a process to be able to attend. So watch out for some of these things as well. Then we have the Toastmasters Club. I've spoken about it. Volunteering opportunities. We have an end-of-year dinner that we do at the end of every year. And we also use that opportunity to reward and recognize hard-working members and volunteers. Okay, there are some people who have gone above and beyond duty throughout the year. And we use those opportunities to sort of recognize them and appreciate their effort as well. Then we have our National Project Management Conference and the PM Excellence Awards, which also happens every year. Usually it's in July. And again, last year was Rock City. This year it was announced yesterday at the chapter meeting. We are going to Aqua Safari 2025. So if you haven't made any plans, start preparing. Financially, check your calendar, check your timelines, and then try and book some leave to be able to be part of those sessions. Because there are sessions that, you know, would give you a lot of information, a lot of knowledge. You can network, and it will grow your horizon as well. So please look out for those ones. Then we have weekly quizzes that we put on the WhatsApp platforms. Every week, I think it's on Mondays, quizzes are posed, and there are questions around project management. For those who are not certified, look out for some of these questions. They are possible PMP exam questions, you know, and it just gives you an idea the sort of questions that they ask during the examination. But if you're able to answer them properly, it also tells you that, yes, you are practicing your profession. So look out for some of those things and then answer them accordingly. So lastly, is that the last slide? Okay. I'd like to say a big thank you to all of you and officially welcome you to PMI Ghana chapter. I'm not sure whether you find your language there, but it's there. One of them. One of them belongs to you. So thank you very much for your attention and welcome to PMI Ghana chapter. I will pause if there are any questions. Frank is here. Derek is here. They can help me to answer that as well before we move on to the next item. But let's just give you a bit of a glimpse on the picture gallery. If you can just go slide. Okay, so this is our 2023 end of year dinner. You see your president there. It's got swag. You know, there are some of the board members. This is the NMPC at Royal St. Jean Akosombo. Scroll down. This is some of the outreach, the giving back to society program that we do. We donate to less fortunate institutions and all that. And these things are basically contributions that we get from members. Okay, so when we did the when we went to Rock City, there was a donation that we made to one of the schools there. We painted the schools, we bought books for them, and it came from your contributions. Everybody contributed. You know, so these are some of the things that we want to impact the community with. This is a health screening that happened at Botiano some time back. Free. Okay, next one. This is a library that we renovated some time back as well. You know, there's a PMI Kenya. Yes, I spoke about the Africa series. So this was, I think, last year, Frank. This last year, yeah. This was the global conference in the US last year. You can see the Ghana team making it. And this is just 2 weeks ago. Uh-huh. If you watch out, you see Frank Ato. He's in the middle somewhere. The ice is still fresh on him. So we attend some of these things, you know, just to broaden our knowledge and all that. So look out for information on your email, look out for information from the WhatsApp platform, and then try and act accordingly. You know, these are some of the strategy sessions that we hold for volunteers. Just write down here. Some of your colleagues who also came through the Akwaaba session, we take photos, end of year dinner. So basically, that's it. We have a number of social media handles. I think these things have been published already. We can put them on the platform again. You know, connect, like, what's the terminology? Like and do it. Comment, share, comment, all those things. All right. So thank you very much. I would pause here and take any questions. Thank you. Yes. I'm within. Okay.
If I heard you right, you said each year you have global conferences.
Yes.
Yeah. And currently, the application for visa from the U.S. embassy, it's gone to 2025. And I don't know whether you have already advertised for where the conference is going to come from. So I don't know. I just want to find out if a member wants to be part of the conference. And now the schedule for the interview is somewhere, if you go now, they'll put you 2025. And it is still building. I just want to find out if there is a certain form of arrangement for such occasions.
Okay, so thank you very much. So what happens is that the venue and the time for the conference on a yearly basis is decided by the global body. Usually at the end of the conference for a particular year, the next date and venue is announced at that conference, right? So for the Atlanta one, that was done last year. As soon as we ended, they announced that the next, they announced the dates for the next conference and the venue, all right? And so you can start preparing, but usually they open up the registration, I think sometime in March, April, March, thereabout. The conference usually happens in either September, October, or November, latter part of the year. And they open the registration around April. So it allows you enough time to be able to apply. And when you register, they give you a letter that shows that you have registered and you want to attend the conference and all that. And you can add it to your documents and submit for visa. However, the visa acquisition process is your responsibility, right? So you have to see how you time yourself to be able to get the visa on time to attend the session, right? So if, for instance, you are planning to attend next year, which is in November 2025, I think they announced it when you, okay, it's in Arizona, Phoenix, Arizona. They've announced it already. November 2025. You can go in there and apply for your visa now, even though you have not registered. You can go in and apply for your visa and state the reasons and choose your date and everything. When the registration opens and then you apply, you get your letter and you can add to your documents and then go for your interview. However, the arrangement of the visa and everything is your responsibility. I mean, the chapter wouldn't necessarily be leading you to do that. We can only help by creating a group that sort of coordinates activities. So those who are going, when are you leaving? Where are you staying? And all that. So that when you get there, you have a community that you can sort of bond with. But in terms of the visa arrangement, that one, you have to arrange it yourself. Unfortunately. I hope I've answered your question. I'm sure it's not the answer you're looking for, but that's the answer. Yes, Frank can add a bit. Okay.
Thank you. So, as Jalilu said, the best way to do it is for you to apply now. The venue is out already, Arizona, in November 2025. Last year, we got the hint earlier that it was going to be held in Los Angeles. So people who wanted to go applied right after the conference. And once on the portal now, the dates are within 2025. Even if you should get somewhere around September, October, you are still within time to prepare for November. If you buy the forms now and fill your DS-160, you are able to select the date, which any date after March or April, when the conference portal will be open for registration. You download your visa form, the visa letter from the portal, and then you are good to go. Last year, we presented 38 people. This year we're 45, and we had about six Ghanaians who were living in the US already joining us over there. Next year we are looking at 60 plus. So Jalil will be leading us there. But please don't, a little delay would lead to you getting into the situation where you would have to get someone to assist you to get, and those ones are very, very, very uncomfortable. And you have to pay. But your hotel is also not part of the conference fees, because we have instances where people have seen the conference fees and are asking whether hotels and flight, it's part of it. Please, it's not. Your hotels can be booked. There are discounted hotels from PMI Global. You can book these hotels, and when you get there, you only pay when you are checking in to lodge. Thank you.
Chief, I hope you're okay with the answer. Okay, thank you. Any other question? Okay.
Yeah.
Kofi, if you can help me.
With I'm here.
Okay.
All right. So my question is on the PDUs as a professional development unit. Now, is it any member of PMI that benefits from the PDUs, or you should have any of the professional certifications in order to benefit from the PDUs? Then the weekly quizzes, are there specific days or timeline to the quizzes when they are dropped, the questions are dropped on the platforms? Thank you.
All right, thank you. So the PDUs for certified members, you know, you have to maintain your certification. And you maintain it by engaging in activities that earns you professional development unit, right? So if you are certified within a certain period, you have to ensure that you attend certain events, take certain activities that would earn you PDUs to maintain your certification. Now, for this event, as an example, you earn PDU if you scan, you know, and then you register. If you come to a chapter meeting at ALISA, you earn PDUs. If you join a webinar, you know, by professional development unit, you earn PDUs. If you join any of the chapter organized activities, you earn PDUs. So once you are certified and you have the intention to maintain your certification, join some of these things to earn your PD. If you are not certified, you don't need PDUs, right? So it's basically for certified members accordingly, okay? And each of the certification have exactly what number of PDUs are required for you to maintain them. You understand? So if you go to pmi.org, you can get all the details there accordingly. Yeah.
I am a member, PMI, but they're not professional. I don't have any of the professional certificates. Yes. Can this PDUs, but I take part in these activities. So can this PDUs be reserved for future use or something?
Okay. So you don't have a house, but you want a door. You have to be a certified member and with the intention to maintain your PDU before you can earn PDUs, right? So that's why we encourage members to take steps to certify, right? So that if you attend an event like this, you earn PDUs, and it shows that you have been doing work. Okay. So unfortunately, if you are not certified, please. And then your second question was on the weekly quizzes. So it is dropped on the platforms. We have three chapter WhatsApp platforms, chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3. And it's put on the chapters every Monday. So every Monday, you see the weekly quizzes being put there. And then it's actually fastest fingers first. So sometimes you can have 10 people answer it correctly, but there's a cutoff. You know, we just take the first 5 or first 4 who have answered it correctly. And then we publish their names. Their names also come into our PM Hub on a monthly basis. Okay, so to your question, it's every Monday. Watch out for it every Monday on all the platforms. If you are not on any of the platforms, let me know. I'll add you. As a member, you are supposed to be on the WhatsApp platforms, either chapter 1, chapter 2, or chapter 3. We also have social 1 and social 2, where you can post some other social activities not related to PMI per se, but it should be ethical, you know, per our guidelines. Okay. I hope I've answered the question. All right. Any other question? Yes.
Okay. So thank you, Jalil. I would want to find out why PMI Ghana chapter, I heard you saying that when there is a global conference, you don't interfere or come in to assist in the visa application process. I would want to find out. Based on the answer, then my next question will follow from there.
So if I say we don't come in, what I mean is that we are not going to give you a statement to go for visa, right? We are not going to front for you to say that you are part of us and then you are going, so some courtesies must be extended to you. What you get is that when you register, you get a letter from PMI Global. And by extension, it is still PMI Ghana, if you understand. You get a letter from PMI Global that says that Mr. Soso and So has registered to attend the global conference. It gives you, in fact, they even ask you to supply them with your passport number and some details. And those details are captured on the letter that's given to you. And then you add that to your documents. We can't interfere because if you go for the interview, there are certain things they are looking for. Your financial stability to be able to go and come. Your accommodation is borne by yourself. The chapter hasn't got enough money to pay for accommodation for everybody. We can't buy tickets for you. So your statement that you add will determine whether you get your visas or not. The way you answer the questions when they are thrown at you will determine whether... And the chapter cannot intervene in that. What we do is to ensure that the portal is open, do your registration, you will get the necessary documentation from PMI Global, and then you can add it to your existing document. The interview is on individual basis, okay? Each one for himself. You understand? Okay,
sure.
So we don't really interfere to a large extent.
Thank you.
I hope I've answered the question.
So that is where now my question will be coming in. Thank you very much. I get the clarity there. But what I have a concern here is not necessarily to assess someone to go through his technical process of interviews at the embassies and other stuff. Like, we are a community. We have joined PMI Ghana. There is a program at PMI Global. I think if even PMI can use that same concept, PMI Ghana can use that same concept of putting these team members together to travel, not necessarily to interfere in anybody's requirements at the visa stage. Because I know even people who are not professionals. I have opportunity, I am a member of about 4 to 5 professional bodies, both locally and international. Now, some of the other professional bodies that I joined, Guidance of Surveyors, Guidance of Engineers, RICS, and the likes, when we have a program like that, there is some kind of organization and coordination to be able to see to it that these are our people, they are traveling. If me, my document is not good, or I have a problem that will not go through, you will tell me, you move the person out of it. Because I was going to California some time back and I was having an issue with the embassy to travel. Because the date was very close, I had to go through the Ministry of Foreign Affairs to get an expedite interview sessions to go through. It got to a point in time I was asking that, can't any of the other professional bodies that I joined could have also stepped in to do this? Because this is a genuine call and it's coming to also help our country. It was an exchange program. So some of these things like this, I think that we are a community. Joining a professional body, there should be some kind of, we should feel belonging. That sense of belonging should be in it. It is also something that I think, it is my humble suggestion that we should look at it from that direction. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you very much. I think your suggestion is well noted. And then my president is here. He's in dark glasses, but he can hear you. And you know, we have a professional body now, so these are some of the things that we can look to see how possible we'll help members on some of these things. But the organization is to the extent that we put together a team that, you know, sort of coordinates all the teams that are going, everybody that's going. We have a WhatsApp platform, when are you leaving, when are you coming back, where are you staying, so that when you get there you can put everybody together for whatever activities we need. But if I hear you right, what you're talking about is everything holistic, not just, you know, when you get there, but how do we even help members to go through other activities as well? and I believe that we have heard you. We'll look at what is possible, and then we'll come back to you accordingly. Yeah.
It is because not everybody is also privy to some of these things. Someone, this may be his first time maybe traveling. It's not like, I understand sometimes the embassy is looking for fraud, you know, America, and they are their security systems. But not every Ghanaian is like that. Not every black man going to a white man's country need to be searched as if we've gone to steal something or the other. So I believe that with the professional body coming, being an organization, things will be easy that way, so that the person who have not traveled before will not be frustrated. Even though he's a genuine person, he has his genuine document, can go through this kind of procedures easily. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Like I said, it's well noted. And then we'll look into it.
The PDUs, if you go to the portal, there's a section that says giving back. I don't know what that means and how we can access that.
We don't have the VP for professional development here. They are, to a large extent, the experts when it comes to some of these things. But I don't know if maybe when my president comes and he has an answer, he will probably provide you. But it's part of the activities. Sorry, volunteer. Okay, it's part of our activities that you do to NPDUs. Okay, but as to the details, I'll leave it for the experts. Yes.
Okay. Hello. Good morning, everyone.
Oh, but you should put on your dark glasses. Right.
I don't want to look too much like a Terminator. Okay, so on the issue of the giving back when it comes to the PDUs, it's got to do with you helping to, let me say, propagate the profession of project management. If you do some form of training for a group of people, or you volunteer like we do, you are entitled to up to 25 PDUs per year. And you can claim that by providing details of what you engaged in. For me, I have never claimed that because the events I attend for the chapter alone is enough to take care of my 60 PDUs for the 3-year cycles. And I can understand why you are so enthused about PDUs. I can understand. You know, when you pass your PMP, the next day you think you wake up with wings so you can fly. So I can understand. But I would entreat you to focus on the weightier matters. Get yourself to be a better person than you joined. The PDUs are automatic. They will fall along the line because Ghana chapter is one of the very few, if not the only one, who uploads PDUs for participants of their activities. For the other chapters, if you join, they will send you an email with a code for you to access it or upload the PDU yourself. But Ghana chapter, we have a volunteer who is in charge and uploads the PDUs for us. It's a Yajiji Yesu too much. So focus on the weightier matters. The PDUs will sort themselves out. But please, don't wait till a day before your certification expires. Don't call Jalilu. Don't call me. Charlie. That thing they expire tomorrow. I don't go busy you. Seriously. I don't mind you. You paid money. You studied on your own to sit for it. It is yours. It is not mine. Take responsibility for it. If it expires, you will have to risk it. Yeah, you lose it. And I've seen members lose their certification and they have to sit and write it again. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. President. Okay. Please.
So if you hit 60, the 60 PDUs before, within the 3-year cycle, for instance, even second year, and you hit it, what happens? The additional, is there a carryover or what?
Somebody said, if you are not certified and you attend, you should accumulate your PDUs and put it down. When you are certified, you bring it. Now, if you are certified and then you get more than the 60, what happens to the rest? Mr. President, I don't know if you have an answer. Okay, cool.
Hello, thank you so much. So myself, I need to renew 90 PDUs for my PMP and PMI ACP, and I've already hit those marks. So when it's already done, it sort of locks it until the next renewal cycle again. So it sort of locks it, and any other activity you go to, it's just maybe pro bono. But because you go to the activity so frequently, it doesn't even get to you that you really have to renew your PDUs, because it's a part of life. Hence, it just comes so naturally. So just like President Frank said, just focus on the weightier matters. The PDUs will come by themselves. That's for the last year. So like the last 6 months to the next renewal cycle, then they sort of, yeah, they sort of get some PDUs that can carry over.
Sorry, just to add, PDUs are not a problem at all, as Frank said. So the strategy to get PDUs is you attend all the 11 chapter meetings in a year. Okay. And that is like 11 times 2. Okay. We have webinars every month. If you attend the webinar every month, you have at least 1.5. So within a year, you've covered all your PDUs. And even the conference, when you can, you have like about 16 to 20 or more. So PDUs is not a problem at all.
Okay, thank you very much. Is there any other question before we move on to the next? Yes, please go ahead. Yes, please.
Yeah, thank you very much. So I know you've already mentioned that PDUs are not a problem because attending conferences and all that can help you gain them. But then, like our colleague mentioned earlier, they are in two parts, the education and the giving back. And President has already mentioned that at the end of the year, you get 5 PDUs for giving back. Meanwhile, it's 25 and you have 3 years to attain your membership. So how often do you organize volunteering activities or giving back programs to help us get more than 5 in a year?
Okay, so I think that as Frank mentioned, the total you need for the 3 years is 60, right? So if you look at the activities that we undertake in a year, there are 11 monthly chapter meetings. There are webinars. We have the National Project Management Conference Awards. We have the branch meetings as well. So if you attend all these things, trust me, PDU should not be a problem. The giving back is, as Mr. President mentioned, if you are engaged in certain activities. For instance, when we went to Rock City, we had members who volunteered to go and help with the school painting and all that. They were there to help with the sharing of the books to the students. So if you take part in all those activities, trust me, PDU should not be a worry for you at all. You understand? So just make sure that if the activities are advertised, you attend, you show up, you take part in it, and the team that would, you know, help you would upload the PDU for you behind the scenes. And that shouldn't be a problem at all. But if you still have further concerns, we can speak afterwards. If you have further concerns on the PDUs, we can speak afterwards to see how we can clarify that for you. Okay.
So I've had the certification for 2 years now.
Okay,
I'm now joining. And so far I think I have 14 PDUs. 14.
So 2 years.
2 years, yes.
14 PDUs.
Yes. Yes, because I've
you've not been doing anything.
Exactly. So with the 1 year left, are you going to assist me in attaining that the difference that I'm supposed to get the 60?
Okay, thank you very much. We'll assist you. How we can assist you is that we will organize the programs. We'll organize the sessions. You have to attend and earn your PDUs. And then you are good to go. Okay, cool. How are we doing with time, Toastmasters? Are we... Any other questions? I think the next activity is for us to do breakfast. Okay, please go ahead. let's take the last question so that we can stick to our, but we are not cutting the questions off. If you still have any further concerns, we are around. Reach out to us. We'll try and help you.
Okay, so on volunteerism.
Yep.
Can you mention a few of the volunteering activities PMI carries out? You know, I just want to know.
Are you talking of the work that volunteers do or some of the activities?
Yes.
Okay, so as I indicated earlier, if you look at the portfolios, we have different portfolios. And each portfolio is headed by a VP or a head. And that those heads are volunteers. Okay? So if you take my portfolio, which is the membership, we have a director of operations. We have a director for new membership, director for member services, director for student affairs, and all that. And they have specific responsibilities that they carry out. Okay? Example, the director for member services is responsible for ensuring that when new members join, they get their welcome emailers. All right? Whatever information that needs to go to them, it gets to them. And then they are asked to sort of contact the VP for membership if they want to be added to the platform. Remember, not everybody who joins wants to be on the platform. So usually we'll get all those information and then we add them onto the platform. The director for student affairs is responsible for all the student activities. We have a student club in most of the tertiary institutions, as you may know. And she's responsible for ensuring that she coordinates the activities. They have a program of activities for the year, and then she helps them to be able to achieve all those things. And at the same time, grow the membership. Okay? So we have student membership, we have individual membership, we have retiree membership. So each of these volunteers are responsible for specific activities. If you go to Outreach, he has a number of volunteers who are looking after things that goes on X, Facebook, public sector engagement, private sector engagement, and all that. So there are specific things that the volunteers do just to make sure that the chapter keeps running.
Okay. So my final question.
Okay.
There are improved project management tools in the system. I want to find out if PMI has sessions where they organize seminars for professionals in certain fields or particular fields and educate them or get professionals to help them understand some of these tools. I don't know if the educational package has any.
So we do. Even at the conferences, in fact, if you attended the last conference, for instance, we had a session where we wanted members who are using certain tools to help them to navigate their project management, you know, flows, to come and exhibit or show or share what they use so that those who don't know can get to know and possibly start to use them. So at the conference, we do some of those things. We also invite experts. You know, if you look at the variety of resource persons that we invite for the monthly chapter meetings, they are diverse. Okay? They speak on different areas. And so as and when there's a need for us to invite people to come and speak to us on tools for project management or the latest innovation in project management, we invite those people to come and speak to us as well. But you can also suggest, based on what you are saying, what are the things that you want to see the chapter do? Where are the areas that you want us to focus on? And then make suggestions, and then we'll look for resource persons to come and address that as well. Even in the professional development space, on a monthly basis, we invite people to speak to us on different areas. So you can make suggestions as to what you want to see, and then we'll see how we get the resource persons to be able to address those things. So you have a role to play as well, not just the volunteers. All right. I hope I've answered the question. Thank you. Are there any other questions or concerns? I'm sure the watcher is getting cold and the shitter and all that. So if there are no further concerns, please, let's take the next 30 minutes. Let's have breakfast. And then whilst you eat, please think about your presentation. The judges are here. They are going to assess you and then give you their comments and their observation. Let's try and stick to the time. 30 minutes. So it's 10:22. 30 minutes, let's be back, please, so that we can continue. Thank you very much.
Toastmasters really is about timing, because we have to make sure that we are on time all the time. It's wonderful to have you all here. You're all in 8 teams, and you're presenting really around the same topic, but really on your symbols as it relates to the topic. And when we are judging you, we'll be looking at these aspects. We are looking at your presentation, presentation of the slide deck and how you actually present to your audience. We are looking at the content itself. Does it relate to the topic in question? Then the logical presentation of ideas of that content that you're actually presenting to your audience. And obviously, yes, we are timing you because we have to be sure that we stick to time and don't get into anyone other. And of course, this is a project management body, so we have to make sure that you are using the appropriate lexicons so that your audience know that, yes, you are speaking the same jargon, more or less. And I'll use this opportunity to jump into Toastmasters before I allow some of my other esteemed colleagues to follow up. What is Toastmasters, first of all? John C. Maxwell says, there's this quote by John C. Maxwell, which just escaped my mind, but really, it talks about leadership. And if you want to be a leader, Toastmasters is the place where you should be a leader, because this is where leaders are made. Toastmasters is an organization with more than 300,000 members. It's greater than some countries, San Marino, Liechtenstein, just to name a few. And so if you are part of Toastmasters, you are part of a bigger body. It's its own professional body where you get to network, where you get to learn, where you get to build your own contacts of associations and friends. Within the Toastmaster body, there are a series of models within which you become a better speaker. So we have 11 learning paths that you could take. You get the opportunity to be evaluated. You get the opportunity to present as well. And in all these, there are some benefits, obviously. With PMI Ghana Toastmasters, you attain PDUs. You attain 1.5 PDUs for every meeting that you join, which accrues to the certifications that you need to renew. And because Toastmasters is such an organized body, it has its own organogram and structure. And I have two persons from the organogram within the Ghana Toastmasters community. We have an area director, and we also have someone who is a district director. And I would like them to come and speak more on the benefits of Toastmasters and how Toastmasters could be of benefit to you. So I have, perhaps I'll let Priscilla Araba speak a little bit first. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Good morning. And I'm happy to see my boss here, Jalilu. We are all in Stambik. So just to go to, or straight to the point, Toastmasters. Toastmasters, somebody will ask, what are you toasting? We don't toast bread, but we rather toast communication, excellence in communicating. And there are three things that you intend to enjoy when you join Toastmasters. I always try to make it very practical because I am a living testament of that journey. I have been in the banking industry for so many years. And in every career, you start from the scratch, especially when you join as a junior officer. But as you climb the ladder, you get to a point where it is not about the BAU or the day-to-day activity. So I'm just using banking as the scenario where if you are a teller, the only expectation of you is to be pushing papers, debit or deposit or withdrawal. We all have the aim of getting to the top. And as you are getting to the top, the expectation is that you should be able to lead. You should be able to influence. You should be able to speak to people's emotion to align with your vision and mission. And this is what Toastmasters does. Years ago, when we are being asked to come for presentation, and I don't know for PMI, but in our career, every month you are asked to come for monthly performance review. And I make it very practical to say that years ago, when I'm going for monthly performance review, I need to lock myself up, practice what to say, pick pen and paper, and try to critique myself and all that. But do you know, I have all the answers. But the moment I'm called to come and present, like what I'm doing, just by seeing my mere colleagues and bosses like Jalilu, I tend to lose my thoughts. Years ago, I can't do what I'm doing, honestly. It's not because I don't know what to say, but there's something called stage fright. There's something called speaking confidently. But today, when I go for NPR, my boss, with all due respect, even if my figures are not speaking to each other, I say it confidently. So you even lie confidently. Because, I mean, you tend to put your thought together. When you join Toastmasters, there are things that you take away with. Speaking within time. We have all been to the universities. We've done our masters, the PhDs, the professors and all that. I was just telling Ellie that I did projects and strategic management years ago. So what is PMI? But when you come to Toastmasters, these things, you don't get it from any of the institutions. No lecturer is going to teach you how to speak within time. Impromptu speeches. So you have to speak thinking on your feet, or bottles thinking. You sit there and somebody asks you a question and all of a sudden you should be able to put your thought together. Where I sit in my institution, we tend to receive leaders from center, SA, and they visit your segment and they just come to you, how are you? So how is business? You should know a little bit about your competitors and then the market, how business. You should be able to speak on top of your voice. We couldn't do that years ago, but Toastmasters will teach you. And then how to moderate. You see people MCing program. There's another aspect in Toastmasters we call Toastmasters of the day. When we are having meeting, you moderate the session from A to Z. When you continue doing these things, before you know it, it can become a side gig for you. That when they need somebody to moderate a section, MC a program, you do it with ease. Another thing is that it offers you the opportunity to do presentations like what you are about to do. And it doesn't end there. You tend to sharpen your skills in PowerPoint presentation because there are courses in Toastmasters. I call it vocational skills. That is the only platform that offers you the opportunity to learn from the base camp, which is the theory bit, and then offers you the opportunity to practice what you have learned. We go for meetings or seminars and we try to invite seasoned speakers to come and teach us how to speak confidently or how to write speeches well and all that. And I used to tell people that they bring these seminars and they ask us early bird, maybe $100. Those who are not able to pay within that time, you pay extra than the $100. When you go for such seminars, they bring in people like Jalilu, come and tell you, these are the traits of a good leader. If you want to speak well, do A, B, C, D. You have your breakfast, you network, and you walk away. Toastmasters is not like that. After learning all those things on the base camp, it allows you to go and select a course, which we call pathways. We have presentation mastering. We have innovative planning. We have motivational strategies. A lot. And before you know it, you are good with PowerPoint presentation. You are good in speaking in public. And you get a bit of finesse around how you speak. And when you are among your team, you always stand out. So not to take much of your time. I know we all belong to different institutions and our aim is to advance in our career. For people to listen to you, for you to think strategically, that is the place to be. There are a lot of clubs. I used to tell people, there are Rotarians, Lions. It's good. We are giving back to society. What are you giving to yourself? We give a lot to our family. We give a lot to our jobs. We give a lot to community. What are you giving to yourself? Personal development is very key. And for me, I just want to encourage each and everyone here. Somebody will ask, how much? Or what does it take to become a Toastmasters? Yes, there's a fee to it. It is $60 for 6 months. And somebody will say $60 and the banking rate and all that. Yes, it is. But I always say that if indeed you are really passionate about this journey, $60 is nothing to write home about. $60, let's assume even the rate is 15. 6 months, we are saying that pay 900 Ghana cedis to learn all these things. And maybe right after this, we may even take some of your contacts to join the sections to know how we organize Toastmasters sections. So 900 for 6 months. And you're saying 900, I don't have it. And I keep saying that, okay, then let's do it bi-monthly. Divide it by maybe 6 months. We are asking you to save 150 Ghana towards a six-month journey. I don't have that 150. I'm saying that do it by daily. It's five cedis. Five cedis by 22 working days will give you 150. We spend more than five cedis a day. If today Jalilu wants to have a drink with me or want to sit over a pork and yam, we'll walk away spending more than 300 Ghana cedis. And it is just for some few hours. So for me, I think that if we want to invest, let's invest rightly. And at the end of the day, we'll look back and say that we've made ourselves proud. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. We'll change the pork and yam to fried rice and proper goats grilled. Okay, is there anything else you want to, before, maybe you want to just give them the, you've given that already. Okay. So I think let's get straight into the meat. Our first theme is collaboration. Can I have members of collaboration please come forward? Please nominate your leader and let one person come and moderate the slides. You did it, so you know exactly how to go about it. Be mindful of the time and all the criteria that the Toastmasters team have outlined. A round of applause for team collaboration.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to PMI headquarters. My name is Edna Magnus, your tour guide for today. Many of you have noticed the new PMI logo right at the entrance of the premises, and I'm sure you are curious and excited to know the relevance of these new symbols on the logo. So in 2019, the PMI Institute underwent rebranding, including a new logo. There is one unique symbol on the logo which represents a characteristic needed by all project managers and team members to be successful. This symbol looks like two people coming together to have each other's back. So it looks like this. Turn your back. Yes. That's the collaboration symbol right there. So what is collaboration? Collaboration is the process of working together with others to achieve a common goal or complete a task. So simply put, collaboration means to co-labor. So collaboration in the context of project management. We are saying in project management, collaboration involves team members, stakeholders, and external parties actively communicating, coordinating, and sharing resources and responsibilities to ensure a project's success. In an agile environment, projects with high variability team structures, such as self-organizing teams and generalizing specialists, maximize focus through collaboration. For projects with a defined scope, deadlines and budgets, effective collaboration enables entire team to work together to be more productive and aware of each other's perspectives to align all contributors towards reducing risk, improving efficiency, and achieving shared objectives. So there are four concepts, okay, that form the backbone for collaboration. One is communication, two is coordination, three is problem solving, four is decision making and resource sharing. We'll look at this four as we go along. Relevance of collaboration to project management. So the four concepts of collaboration, how is it relevant to project management? One, the concepts help to improve coordination, communication as it promotes open and clear communication among team members. Two, collaboration is relevant to effectively involve and engage stakeholders throughout the project. Three, it enhances problem solving because team members bring different perspectives to problem solving. Four, collaboration in project management helps to identify risk early and develop strategies on how to mitigate the risk. Five, collaboration fosters workflow coordination, leading to increased efficiency. How does collaboration inspire project success? But let's first define project success. Kesner defined project success as completion within time, cost, and specifications, as well as with minimum or mutually agreed scope changes and acceptance by a client or user. So is collaboration necessary? Why is it necessary? Collaboration fosters better innovation. It increases team morale. It helps to fasten problem solving, and it also leads to higher productivity. If we are saying collaboration is important, what are, in the absence of collaboration or having a poor collaboration, what happens to projects? The project manager faces delays in project timelines because miscommunication can lead to tasks being misunderstood or neglected. Poor collaboration also reduces the quality of work. Issues are not addressed early, leading to poor results in requirements or standards. Resources are ineffectively used, including human and material resources, hence wastage. Four, poor collaboration leads to frustration among team members, and it affects team morale and can cause decrease in productivity. Low productivity leads to failure in achieving project objective. So let's look at as a case study, an ancient project, and how the presence and absence of collaboration affected the outcome of the project. So the title of the project is the Tower of Babel. I'm sure we all know or have an idea as to this project. So the background of the story is derived from a biblical account. This involves humanity's attempt to build a tower reaching the heavens. Their objective was to build a tower to reach the heavens and make a name for themselves. So they collaborated in their planning, in their initiation, planning, executing the phase. And the outcome was that they were successful. But there was a divine intervention to destroy their collaboration. God confounded their language, causing confusion and miscommunication. So there was poor collaboration, which stifled the project's objective. But the people initially were stronger together. So I leave all of you with these three critical aspects of collaboration as project management. One, you have to have a unified vision or goal as team members. Two, there has to be effective communication in all you do. And then three, you have to build coordination. So the collaboration team, we are here to say, through collaboration, we are stronger together. Thank you.
Thank you very much, team collaboration. Okay, so please, the time allotted is a total of 5 minutes. A total of 5 minutes. So let's try and work within that time, please. Thank you. So the next team is outcome. Team outcome. Let's do it quickly. A round of applause for team outcome. Okay, take it away.
Thank you very much. So, we are team outcome, yes. So, the Project Management Institute has been the forefront of advancing project management practices over 50 years. Our mission is to support project managers and organizations in delivering value through successful projects. At PMI, we believe focusing on brand identity helps us to speak to our mission and impact. It's not just about completing tasks, it's about understanding how those tasks contribute to meaningful change in the world. This principle drives us to strive for excellence in every project undertaking. So it's not just about you having a project idea, but the impact it makes afterward. And project outcomes are results that occur from creating your project, your product, or service. They are changes in policies, people, and community that you aim to achieve with your work or with your project. So outcomes may be positive or negative. And sometimes they happen unintentionally. Yeah, so these statements are specific and measurable, letting you know when you accomplish your goal.
Introduction of the PMI symbol. This symbol encapsulates the essence of our approach to project management. The design elements reflect growth and connection with vibrant colors, representing energy and optimism. It serves as a reminder that successful projects are those that lead to positive societal impact, not just process completion. And the meaning behind the new PMI symbol. The PMI symbol represents more than just a visual element. It embodies our commitment to celebrating the impact of our work. When we say we celebrate outcomes, we acknowledge that every project has the potential to transform communities and improve lives. Consider community development projects that provide essential services. These projects can lead to cleaner water, better health care, and improved education. Each of these outcomes contributes to a healthier, more sustainable society. Now, the relevance of project management is we've captured it in three parts. The first one, it encourages project management to set clear goals. Now, when we do that, we are defining what success looks like as a team. And this is very crucial, as we all know. It's also, is it a new infrastructure project? Are we improving community? Is it improved community engagement we want to achieve as an outcome? By being clear about desired outcomes, project managers can align their efforts accordingly. Now, the third one is engaging stakeholders, which is key. It's paramount. Successful projects involve collaboration with those who will become affected by the outcomes. By involving the community and other stakeholders, project managers ensure that projects meet real needs. And finally, evaluating the impact of projects is essential. By measuring success, which we've clearly stated from the first one, we are able to put in terms societal benefits. Project managers can define the approaches for future projects. So
Before we conclude our presentation, we would like to look at some benefits of understanding project outcomes. So one, you have to determine if your project meets business objectives. So what are you aiming to achieve? And you have to know what is the need. Maybe the need is to cater for sick people or build an infrastructure to cater for the sick and to cater for the sick. So you have a project to build a hospital. So what is the outcome of the hospital? How is your hospital going to benefit the society or the community that you are putting that infrastructure into? So you have to look at the outcome of that project. So it's not just about the processes that you go through to build your infrastructure, but then what is the outcome? What are the benefits of your project? So that's what we are looking out here. And also, you have to provide the overall purpose of your project, discover ways of meeting the needs of your clients, and helping to make sure all parts of the project serves the end goal. And so in conclusion, the project, the PMI symbol is our logo. In our logo, it's a powerful reminder of what we are as project management and what we aim to achieve. It encourages us to celebrate positive changes our projects can bring to society. I invite each of you to reflect on how you can collaborate this focus on PMI in your future projects. Let's work together to create a world that strives on meaningful results. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Team Outcome. A round of applause for the two-woman team. Okay, we'll move straight ahead. The next team is Team Growth. Team Growth, are you here? A round of applause, Team Growth. Thank you.
All right. Hi, good morning. So I'm going to use a tour because the question said you're given a tour. And I'm going to start our tour with a quote from Oprah saying we can't become what we need to become unless we've changed from what we are. Now, project management or PMI being an institution focused on continuous improvement, realize that project management is much more broader than just managing a project. It included programs, portfolios, and other agile methodologies. So they embarked on a little change management process, which included in the changing of the logo. Next slide. So we define the growth symbol as the continuous development and expansion, which speaks to personal growth and team growth and project growth. As we all know, no project is the same. Every project has a learning curve, and based on the learning curve, the project manager and the team and people who need the future references or need to develop on the project can learn and grow from the project. Next slide. Like I said, every project seeks to bring a positive change and create value. Growth also refers to the development of the project and the development of the project manager and the project team. Next slide. All right. How the growth symbol inspires project success. Successful projects must grow through their life cycles from iterative improvement, learning from feedback, and adapting to changing circumstances. So as we learned from our agile methodologies, during retrospections, we go back to see what we did, if we had any issues, what we can improve on, and how we can make it better or how we can get the project into a successful completion. Next slide, please. All right. So to conclude, we said the growth symbol in PMI's logo is more than just an element. It is a representation of the continuous improvement and expansion the project management drives. Thank you.
Determination. Team Determination. How determined are you? Round of applause for Team Determination.
Water from Ponya Boa, and I'll be your tour guide today. We'll delve into the importance and significance of having determination in project management. So this is the outline of our slides, where we have the introduction to determination, understanding the symbol of this determination, the key elements of the symbol, the importance of determination, some real-world applications of determination in project management, and our conclusion. You can go. Yeah, so introduction to determination in project management. Determination is the driving force behind every successful project. Project management represents the relentless pursuit of your goals despite the challenges that you have, the setbacks, unexpected changes, and the reminder of the mental toughness you need, and resilience and unwavering commitment needed to bring projects to life. So in a project management, the path is not a straightforward path. You need resilience, you need the mental toughness to keep going on. You need the determination to make sure your project is successful. So understanding the symbol of the determination. The PMI determination logo features abstract design elements that convey forward momentum, the strength needed to keep this momentum going, and the persistence or the resilience needed to also keep going forward. You know the end goal, you know that you need determination to continue moving forward to reach your end goal. So these shapes are not just artistic choices. They are carefully crafted to reflect the energy and drive that a project manager must have to navigate the complexities of any project. So these are the key elements of the symbol determination. So the bold lines and arrows, they suggest movement and direction. You know, lines, arrows, it suggests that you have a clear goal and movement also. So project management is about moving a project forward and making progress one step at a time. Milestones, wherever you reach, you make sure you are getting towards your end goal, even when the path is not straightforward. So upward trajectories, if you look at the determination logo, it's upward. It means you are supposed to move forward, keep the momentum going. So this symbol represents growth, improvements, and overcoming obstacles. Project management is really a straight line, as I said earlier, and it involves climbing over hurdles, pushing boundaries to achieve your objectives. And also, as you can see for the logo, it has dynamic shapes. So this also represents interconnected, the idea of constant motion and adaptability. You need to be adaptive. You need to keep changing. If this path doesn't work for you, you try another approach. You're determined to reach your end goal. So this is basically what the symbol signifies. Okay, so the importance of determination in project management. One, overcoming challenges. As you can see from the picture, the guy is climbing, rock climbing. So he has an idea of where he wants to be, the end goal. So he's overcoming the challenges, the tiredness he's feeling, the stress, the strain on his body. The end goal is ahead of him. He needs to get there, and he's determined to climb and keep going forward. Secondly, inspiring team resilience, inspiring team and building resilience. As you can see from the picture below, everybody in the team, they all are determined to reach their end goal. As you can sample at beneath, carrying others, some two are finished and urging them on to keep going. So it inspires team building and also their resilience in the team. Staying focused, as the guy is climbing and as the people are holding the log, they are all focused on their goals. So it's also inspiring the team. They are resilient to reach their end goal. And also adapting to change. Yes, as you are climbing, you face obstacles. You change your approach, how you do things, and you reach your end goal. Yes. Okay, so determination symbol embodies the spirit of adaptability, as I said earlier. Being firm in one's goals while being flexible in the approach You don't always need one approach to get your project to be successful. So it's a crucial mindset for thriving in today's fast-paced project environment. So this is a real-world application of determination in project management. So as you can see here, this picture embodies everything that's here: infrastructure, technology, and crisis management. Your technology might be there, but if you are not determined to keep it moving, you're not reaching anywhere. In crisis management, if you are not determined to manage this crisis effectively, you also not get anywhere. So determination is a key factor in our lives that we need to embody as project management. So in conclusion, the PMI determination symbol is a powerful reminder of the core values that drive project management success. It represents the resilience, the focus, and persistence needed to tackle challenges head-on. This symbol is not just a visual element. It's a daily reminder of what it takes to lead projects successful. So as we are all here, it's determination that brought us here. If you're not determined to grow and continuously improve, you'll not be here. Those worried about PDUs, you need determination to keep your PDUs going. So it's all part of determination. We must embody determination in our daily lives and our projects to be successful. Thank you very much.
Teamwork.
Okay.
Hello. Yeah, we are teamwork, and I think you can see that because of our numbers. Yeah, so so these are our team members. We titled our project Building Project Success Through Teamwork, and that is why we are here. That is why we are here. Next slide. So the PMI logo was changed in 2019, and this was because they wanted it to be more representative, to resonate with the evolving and diverse membership that the PMI has. So we know that projects are delivered by people, but winning projects are delivered by teams. Project management comes with a lot of challenges. Some include communication breakdowns, stakeholder misalignment, scope creep, and then resource constraint. And to overcome some of these challenges, we would have to communicate more, support each other as team members, and then as well as define our roles clearly. And these would help us to overcome some project management challenges. The quote here says that no matter how brilliant your mind or strategy, if you are playing a solo game, you would always lose out to a team. So we have to come together to build ourselves and to support ourselves when it comes to projects. And that is why we should work as a team. So the teamwork symbol is a representative of diverse skills, roles, and strengths, which come together to help us achieve our common goal. So projects, the meaning and the relevance of teamwork is to help us increase our efficiency and productivity, as well as it helps combined effort. There's also more accountability when it comes to project, and then it helps foster respect for one another. There's less friction if we are together as a team, and then it also helps for open communication and positive feedback. So a case study is the project called Apollo 11 moon landing, which happened in 1968. So it is a successful project that attributed its success to teamwork. The mission was a historic achievement because it required collaboration among thousands of individuals from various disciplines, including astronauts, engineers, technicians, and scientists. The success was credited to exceptional teamwork, communication, and coordination among team members. The commander of the mission, who was Neil Armstrong, he said that the mission was a resounding success, and it was a direct result of incredible teamwork and dedication of every single person involved. So he says that alone, Helen Keller says that alone we can do so little, together we can do so much. So to conclude, teamwork is the backbone of every project managed, every project. And then by fostering collaboration, communication, mutual support, we can unlock project success. So we have to work together as a team to build a culture of teamwork and achieve project excellence. Thank you.
Thank you very much. A round of applause for teamwork. Community, are you ready? Team community, a round of applause for team community. Who's?
Okay, good morning to you all. We happen to be here as your tour guide, your humble servants. I will be your tour guide for this tour at the PMI headquarters. This is team community, and our slogan, we say, fostering a sense of belonging. So these are the team members. We want you to be familiar with our slogan here, that when we talk about community at PMI, we mean we want every team member to feel project management community. Once again, you are welcome to the museum at the PMI headquarters. To share with you the significance of the community symbol. As you notice, our new logo comprises of several interconnected elements. The community symbol simply represents the foundation of project management. So when we talk about community, you can find innovation, you can find all the teamwork, every other symbols within the community. People working together towards a common goal or aim. Now, let me quickly break down the symbol community. If you look at this round symbols put together here, what it means is that if you see the interconnected circles, it represents one, collaboration, teamwork, as I said earlier, stakeholder engagement. Again, in this same community symbol, you come across what we call diverse shapes and sizes, which also embodied inclusivity or being inclusive, bringing people together, diversity and adaptability. Again, in the same symbol, you see a central hub of all the individual symbols coming together, signifying the project manager's role in connecting and facilitating projects. Now, if you look at this picture, we are talking about community of project managers, people from different backgrounds. Now, in project management, community is very vital, very key here. Why do we say so? It helps in stakeholder engagement and communication. It brings team collaboration and motivation, resource allocation and management, and conflict resolution and issues mitigation. Now, as a tour guide, I want you to look at something here, that when we talk about this community symbol, it inspires project success by one, fostering open communication and trust. So in this case, you realize that whenever you look at the picture that we have put here, you see someone who is a disabled,
someone who is coming from a different background altogether. The symbol community inspires promoting diversity of thought and innovation. It also encourages active participation and ownership. And it also enhances problem solving and decision making, like the team who are in the picture over there. Some examples of successful community-driven projects is like the same at PMI. We have what we called chapters in every country. So the Ghana chapter PMI, you see, as we establish a Ghana chapter in every country, they are able to have a community-led infrastructure project or a disaster relief effort, like the picture that I've shown you there, and also open source software development. At PMI here, we prioritize community through, one, chapter meetings. And I believe we have all been enjoying this as aspiring project managers who have been coming for chapter meetings, volunteering, PMI Educational Foundations, PMI Career Centra, webness events and meetings, blogs and templates, PMI membership and certification, and a collaborative research and standard development. As aspiring project managers who have come for tour at the PMI headquarters, I want you to always remember that community, and I emphasize again, community is the heartbeat of our projects, and we need to nurture it, and we will be able to unlock, one, improve collaboration, increase stakeholder satisfaction, enhance project outcomes. In conclusion, the community symbol represents the power of people coming together to achieve project success. As you continue to tour at the PMI Museum, remember the significance of this symbol and how it inspires project managers worldwide to build and lead high-performing teams. Thank you for your attention, and I welcome any question. Thank you. So these are the profiles of our team members. These are the profiles of our team members. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Team Community. A round of applause for Team Community.
So please, a quick one, because of our community engagement and fostering that belonging, we have a gift here for all the team members in here. We have a gift here for you. Thank you very much. Oh, I can't see you being happy. Oh, our tourists, aren't you happy? Great. So please, the gift is coming, please.
Thank you. See them. Thank you, Team Community. Team Innovation, are you ready? Team Innovation, are you ready? Ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause for Team Innovation.
Okay, so as the name suggests, we are the Team Innovation. There are more of us, but this is us. But it's also new. The Lensa is all part of inspiring the newness. So we'll just go straight, since most of you have gone history and so on the key milestones that has made PMI remain relevant, since it's about newness all the time throughout the years. And in a snapshot, this is how it has been over the years since it was founded in 1969, which started with a group of friends having dinner and then decided that it's going to be a professional body. And this is what now we are enjoying. So, and we are comparing it to global events, how they've decided to remain relevant throughout the years. So between 1969 to 1979, that started, they built the foundations, and it started primarily through volunteerism. To compare, at the same time that Apollo 11 was also founded, which was also a big thing, the first time that the Americans went onto the moon. Then we moved to the next decade, 1979 to 1989, that decided to to begin the professional certification, which now has also become a big thing, yeah? And then the first, one of the co-founders was the first to be certified in the history of PMI. At that same time, too, we had Motorola. And the Motorola was invented, and now we are even using Android all through the years. Then what, as the years were going past, another decade comes, they're still needed to be innovative and keep on inspiring the newness. So they decided to build a global headquarters in Pennsylvania. At the same time, Delta Airline Terminal 5 was also built, and it was named the PMI Project of the Year. So moving on, still to remain relevant, next decade comes, 1999 to 2009, it says PMI, TNI was extending globally. So the move beyond America and then on and on and on, New Orleans, and now they're even in Ghana, having the foresight ahead and inspiring the newness. And at that same time, the DNA double helix too was also discovered as a gene type. Then we move to the next decade. It's like every new decade, something exciting must happen. So now they even expand even more globally. Now they have offices in Australia, Dubai, United, and now we're even in Ghana, in West Africa. At the same time too, the Burj Khalifa, at that time they call it the Burj Dubai, was also built. So you see, they align with what is going to remain relevant along the years. Then, now we are in this new decade, they decided to launch a global brand, and they called it Make It a Reality, and we are still realizing that reality. And now they decided to go to Operation Warp Speed. What happened was that it just facilitated when COVID came, 2019, our presence was felt. So basically, it's an innovative team, and we keep on inspiring new years as the years go by. So I'll hand over to my colleagues who, and this is the old logo, old versus the new logo, which was explained by the earlier team. So we'll go and we'll make it relevant now to what the innovation symbol means. Thank you.
Okay, so as you said, with the innovation, we are still inspiring newness. So every day there's something new, the vision changes. Within project management, innovation keeps changing, things keep changing, and we have to adapt to the changes that is going on within organizations and within the communities. Within the symbol, the colors that is being used within the innovation symbol is a sense of belonging. So within the logo uses symbols from the language of project economy. The innovation symbol harnesses a strategy of change to turn vision into reality. And when it comes to embracing change and embarking on new projects, innovation is one quality that is arguably very important for everything that we do within project management. The violet color that is used represents the nurturing spirit within the project management community. It is a spirit of togetherness and it also nurtures the personality within the project management community as a whole. We also understand that what our community needs, it helps people to improve on what they are doing, and also we celebrate each other. That is why we represent, the innovation represents the color purple, or violet, if you want to say. So within project management, it requires thinking outside the box and coming up with new innovation solutions to problems. And once we are innovating and inspiring changes and newness, we also avail ourselves to take risk and to keep changing day in and day out and not restrict ourselves to the old ways of doing things. But as you change your factors of whatever it is that you're doing, you know that whatever we are creating is new and we want to continue improving on. So even changing our symbol is an innovation that we've taken upon ourselves as project management community as a whole.
With the comparison made over the years, over the decades by PMI, it tells us that innovation is actually relevant when it comes to the PMI institution. To start with, adaptive to change. We realize that in our daily activities, our projects, along the line, we hit and then we have to do some changes. If the innovative mindset of if you are not innovative enough, you are stuck. But then the fact that PMI is incorporating innovativeness in our activities, we are able to adapt to change easily when we encounter some difficulties in the line of our activities or projects. Then technology. Over the years, things keep changing. And with that mindset or with innovativeness, you are able to adapt to the change, adapt to the molding trends, and adapt to make things new. Before, in the banking industry, we know there was cash, the use of cash everywhere. But I realize that now everything is cashless. Where machines or things are produced for us to go cashless. The same as organizations going paperless. These are all innovative minds that PMI or project managers came along to bring to board. Then we go to the global and then appealing nature of innovativeness in our institution. You realize that innovativeness brings or attracts lots of people on board. The young, the old, and even globally, PMI is all over the world. We have chapters in all the nations, and this is based on the innovativeness of PMI. Then in conclusion, there is one thing I would want us all to take home, and that is vision coming into reality, and that is through innovativeness. If you are not innovative, your visions will not come to reality. Thank you. Innovation.
Team Innovation, thank you very much. A round of applause for Team Innovation. Team Vision, are you ready? Vision. Depending on which school you went to, you say vision or vision. A round of applause for Team Vision. I went to a good school.
Yes, you kindly help us.
Okay, cool.
Hello. I'm Jennifer. Welcome to the PMI Headquarters Museum. As we explore the rich history and evolution of the Project Management Institute, you may have noticed the new logo with its intriguing symbols. Today, we'll be guiding you through the meaning and significance of those symbols, especially vision. So when I say Team Vision, kindly respond, keep your dreams alive. Team Vision. This catchphrase encapsulates the essence of vision in project management. It's about leading the way, setting a course, and steering the project towards success. These are the team, but for now we have Jennifer Poe and
Colin School.
Okay. So we are here to guide you through it all. PMI has created 10 unique symbols that represent the language of the project economy. To celebrate its 50th anniversary, eight of these symbols are available for everyone in PMI to use, but two are restricted and used only for specific purposes. When the Project Management Institute was founded 50 years ago, project management wasn't really a recognized institution or profession. It started with a small group of people who were discussing new tools and methods. So let's just say it all started with a vision. Everything that we are celebrating, networking, all started with a vision. So let's talk about this vision. Overview of the new logo. In project management, the vision symbol means coming up with new ideas to solve new challenges. It represents perspectives, seeing the big picture, and the ability to create solutions for now that are sustainable for generations to come. So the vision symbol also represents a clear picture of the desired future or end result of a project. It helps project teams and stakeholders understand the overall goal and direction. So it's all about seeing what is to come in 10 years. So you are able to see it with the third eye, what most people describe as the third eye, and then believing in it to carve through whatever you have in mind. Vision symbol and its relevance to PMI. We have the strategic alignment. It aligns you with what you want to do. If you know where you are heading, you know the type of car to take, and then you notice when the car is taking the wrong route. It's just like that. So with strategic alignment, vision ensures that projects are aligned with the long-term goals of the organization or any other team that is involved. So if it's a project, you know what you are doing in the long run, hence you move towards it in that direction. There's inspiration and motivation. If you know what you are about, you are motivated. No matter what challenges or what comes your way, you are compelled to be motivated per what you have in mind. I want to create a pen so that it will help people to easily write and not suffer to get tools to write. Hence, if I see any obstacle or anything that is pushing me to give up, I remember that I want to help people get pens to write. Decision making. With a clear vision, project management can make informed decisions, even in the face of uncertainty. It serves as a compass, guiding the project through challenges and ensuring that every step taken leads closer to the desired outcome. So in conclusion, as you continue your tour of the PMI Museum, we hope you now have a deeper understanding of the vision symbol and its significance in project management. Remember, a clear vision is not just a symbol. It's the driving force that turns ideas into reality and projects into success. Team Vision, keep the dreams alive. Thank you.
Thank you very much, everyone. I think we can do better. Let's give all of them a big round of applause. It's not easy, you know, forming teams in 2 days. Some were here, they were still forming their teams, but they managed to present. You know, it's not easy. Another round of applause for everybody, please. Thank you very much. So we will move on straight to the next set of activities. Whilst we allow the judges to compile their results, they are using white sheets, not pink sheets. Okay. So they'll come back and tell us what the assessment of your presentations are. But I'd like to call on Mr. President. We want to move on with the presentation of certificates. As I indicated earlier, there's a date on the certificate. Please don't allow that date to expire. Laminate it, frame it, put it somewhere that you can see on a daily basis, and ensure that you renew your membership before that date expires. So I'll call on Mr. President to do the presentation of certificates. To all of you as a symbol of your membership to PMI Ghana chapter. A round of applause for yourselves. Let me get that.
Hello. Okay, so a story is told of a man who was on board a vessel, a ship, and saw people drinking wine, expensive wine, chicken, eating a lot of things. And in his mind, he didn't have enough money, so he was just hiding in his corner. Until they got to the destination, then he approached one of them and said, "Charlie, the chicken and everything you guys were enjoying, you must have spent a lot of money." He said, no, it's all part of the fare we paid. Everything is inside. And a lot of us find ourselves in this situation where you join a group like this and all you do is to sit on the fence. And at the end of the year, you approach the president
I thought when I join, I would get a job, but the year has ended and I didn't get a job. Whose fault? All the leadership of the chapter, we are all volunteers. My membership lasts 4 days, and I paid exactly the same amount everyone else pays. You are here today. You have a choice to make to only remember how nice the wache was, or build a network from here. Somebody got up and said, okay, I'm leaving my role. We are looking for replacement. Another member reached out to him, and now he's there, working there. Your CVs, sometimes when you are in town, you think everybody knows your name because your CVs have gone too wide. And still nothing is happening. Change your style. Perhaps the next opportunity is in the pocket of the next person. I know people who can leave here without taking a single contact. And they will call me tomorrow. Prezo, please, the lady who was sitting beside me, do you have contact? So it is up to you to make a decision. Look at the money you paid, unless someone paid it for you. If you walk to a shop with that amount of money, I don't think you will turn and walk back without receiving the item you paid for. We have opened up the opportunities to you. It is up to you to take. When I became a member, I said, no, I want to see what is going on at the top there. So I set myself out to go there to find out what is at the top there. And I've seen. If you also want to, it's at the top there. When my sister was talking about the public speaking, there were days who I was put on a program, church program, and the day I will see my name, I will not go to church. Yes, it's I'm telling you the reality. But I took up some of these opportunities, right? So let's take advantage of what has been provided. It is not always about what is in it for me. Sometimes you get what is in it for you when you are doing, when you are serving others. So let's focus on the network and ensuring that we are part of the events that we organize. Save money to attend conferences. Sometimes when you look through your wardrobe, you realize, Charlie, you get nothing. Get one good suit, one good jacket, and save for the next conference, Kobe. You too, you will know. It's not always about cement, any blocks, any kaswasase. Eh? Develop yourself, and at the right time, you will reap in bountiful folds. Thank you. I should be bringing you a bill for publicizing you. Just a quick one. Before we do that, those of us who joined our chapter meeting yesterday, either virtually or in person, we spoke about this. The chapter set out to register as a professional body because, as it were, PMI operates as a not-for-profit organization globally. So the chapter has existed since 2011, operating as a not-for-profit organization. In better terms, NGO. So the government has any issue and needs technical advice, the government will go for the list of professional bodies and consult them. And the chapter was not on it. So the chapter was looking to catch the eye of the government for some of these things, but it wasn't forthcoming. We had to start from the very foundation by registering as a professional body last year. And what happens is that that professional body called the Project Management Institute Ghana, one can only become a member when you are a member of PMI Global and PMI Ghana chapter. So if you see this professional body and you want to become a member, you'll be directed to the top. Go join PMI, join the chapter, then you become part of the professional body. On May 21st, 2024, we took the list of members in good standing on that day and presented them to the Register of Professional Bodies, paying 25 Ghana cedis per head for that number of members. We have taken delivery of certificates, membership certificates for all these members. What it means is that you have the certificate practice project management in Ghana, backed by the laws of the Republic of Ghana. And that is just the beginning. There are certain organizations who pay professional body fees for staff. Hitherto, our members send their fees to their HR and they look at the chapter and they say, no, this is not a professional body, we will not pay. But going forward, self in that situation, this is a proof for you. But there are dynamics. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. There are dynamics. We are to renew this on your behalf every year by paying 25 Ghana cedis to the Register of Professional Bodies. You also have to be in good standing with PMI and the chapter before you would also be recognized as being in good standing here. So if the day comes and we mine the data of members in good standing and your membership has expired from PMI, your name will not be presented. The issue is that the certificate is printed once, but the office, our secretariat, would verify each member's certificate annually. If you decide to stay without renewing your membership, at that point, your organization writes to us to confirm whether you were a member or not. On that date, you are not a member. And we will write to your organization as it is. So you came in yourself, nobody forced you. Full authority over your professional development. So these certificates will be issued to the members here who were part of the 1,385 and are here. Your certificate is here because you indicated that you will be here. We did not bring yours here because it's bulky. We can't carry everything here. So when you hear your name, you will see some receiving two certificates, some receiving one. That would be the reason. Then for the chapter itself, it is important, Jalilu mentioned it, you take note of your date of expiry. That date, just as the wedding anniversary is important to the bride, let this be important to you. Because when it expires beyond a certain point, when you are rejoining PMI, you will pay the initial $10 again. And that would be something you could have saved. So try as much as possible to note the dates. Thank you very much.
Thank you, President. So let's do this quickly. If you hear your name, you come through this side, you take your certificate, in front of this banner. Photo, are you ready? Okay, cool. We have Belinda Coley. Belinda Coley. Next one, Ajua Echa Dako. Get ready. Yeah. Frida Makati. Frida Makati, please get ready. Florence Nightingale Badon, please get ready. Thank you very much, Florence. Michael Otu, please get ready. Daniel Nikwe, please get ready. Edna Magnus, please get ready. Edna, are you here? Collins Kweku, are you ready? Dorothy Okai. Dorothy Okai. Godwin Jr. Dorothy. Godwin Jr. Annie Marie. Thank you very much. A round of applause for yourselves, please. A round of applause. Thank you very much. At this point in time, we will call our judges to read out the assessment on the white sheets so that we can crown the winner or the winners. We have three categories, first, second, and third. And as I indicated, you'll be published in PM Hub if you win. Okay? So I'll call on Ellie to give us the verdict. Thank you.
Hello, good afternoon. Well done to all of us. Let's give ourselves a round of applause. We've all done so well this morning and this afternoon in giving our presentations. But what I'll do is I'll just attempt to give a remark or evaluation on each team, and then my colleague will come and give us a general evaluation and who was first, second, and third. Okay. Well, I must say you all have the Toastmasters spirit in you, and I believe that after this session, you'd even be more motivated to pursue Toastmasters. So I'll start with Team Growth. Where is Team Growth, please? Team Growth. Wonderful. All right, so maybe I'll just speak to you. On the good side, I love the way there was coordination between yourself and your team member where he was actually controlling the slides. And I love the way you used some PMI lexicon. I remember the words agile, retrospective, especially being used quite often. But on the other side, the slides were quite wordy. When I say wordy slides, there was a lot of text on the slide, which meant that you were really expecting your audience to read all that text on the slide. A lot of the slides were white, plain white slides, which didn't make it so engaging for the audience. And a lot of the time, the speaker was actually reading from the slide. So I believe that perhaps that could be improved in subsequent sessions. I recorded a time of 2 minutes and 48 seconds for you. So thank you and well done. Let's go to team determination. Where is the team determination? Okay, great. What I loved was that similar to the other team, yes, there was some coordination where one was actually presenting and another person was on the laptop controlling the slides. I love the way the pictures visualized what determination was about. There was one particular slide that had three pictures with someone climbing a mountain and such. That was really visual of what determination is all about. And you said it a lot in the presentation, resilience. Also, I love the way before you ended the presentation, you added a bit of humor and laughter to which the audience just engaged with. So that was audience engagement, and that was good. On the other side, your flaws, you were reading a lot from the slides. There were a lot of filler words. Filler words are things like so, and I believe you were using so a lot during the presentation to fill in the gaps. And yes, you were always looking at, I don't know, where is the actual presenter? Yes, you, yes. You were always looking at this part of the audience, hardly ever moving your head. And I believe maybe in subsequent presentations, and after, of course, you do join Toastmasters, we clear all of those bits. Great. Yes, the time was 5 minutes, 6 seconds. Well done. Let's go on to teamwork. They had a lot of persons on the floor. Wonderful. You were a full team, and then all the team members represented on the podium, which was good. There was a focus on the symbol, and I believe there was one slide in particular that hinged and spoke a lot about the symbol, and that was commendable. The slides were engaging, and I love the way there was a particular focus on the case study. On the plus side, yes, there were filler words. I believe I recorded a bit of souls and arms in the speech. And you were reading from the slide and the phone. Your time was 3 minutes, 30 seconds. Thank you so much. Team community. Where's team community? I want to speak to you. Good. I love the way you began with a slogan. And a slogan is a good way to help us remember what your speech is about. So it was that's a good. And I love the way you began with the museum experience from start to the end. You didn't at any point divert from it. A lot of the teams began by saying, okay, welcome to the museum, and that's where they cut it short. They didn't ever refer to the museum tour and experience, but you sort of kept that from the beginning to the end. Yet you also showed the old and the new logo so that we could see the contrast. You spoke to the slide, and you were not really reading from the slide, which was commendable. So you were really, the slide and the text were there, but you were not really reading from the slide. You were sort of explaining what was on the slide, which was commendable. And you infused a lot of PMI Ghana pictures, which was relevant because we are a PMI Ghana community other than picking pictures from any other environment. On the other side, there was not much participation from the other team members in the presentation. It seemed that there was only really one particular person who was presenting, and a lot of the time the back was to the audience. So if you actually are engaging your audience, you shouldn't be reading from the slide, but you should be talking and having us engage together. And your time was 5 minutes, 32 seconds. Team collaboration, please. Good. I love the way you're all together, ready to receive. Okay, on the good side, the slides were beautiful. I loved one picture in particular which spoke to collaboration, which is the Babylon story. And we know the Babylon story, that in the end, God had to even come down to break apart bring different languages to let that project fail, which emphasizes the impact and relevance of collaboration. I loved also the physical gestures, which you did. So when you were actually trying to explain collaboration, then two persons brought their backs together, and even at the end, you brought your hands to use the Wakanda sort of symbol, Black Panther symbol. That was well done. Thank you so much. And on the other side, you were reading from the slide, and there was so much text again on the slide, which made it so wordy and not as engaging as anyone else. The time was 6 minutes, 58 seconds. And you have to remember that we're actually trying to be within time and use 5 minutes. So, well done. It was a good effort. Team outcome. Okay. You were looking at the audience. That's a good thing, especially the second speaker. You were intentional about looking at the audience when trying to speak. And you spoke to the need of outcome as it relates to project management. And I saw that really highlighted in one or two of the slides. On the other side, you were reading from
those of you who are not yet Toastmasters, fortunately, this organization is the only professional body that I know of that has made Toastmasters as one of its pillars. I'm a lawyer, and I'm a lawyer of maybe 34 years standing, okay? We don't have this, even though we need it more, but we don't. So this is something you don't want to miss. You want to take advantage of. And I can tell you, all the guys that you admire who speak very well, they are Toastmasters. If you Google, you'll find. Okay? So I just want to encourage all of you. We have your contact. We are going to create a group, and we engage you, those of you who are interested. Fortunately, we have a club within the organization. There are two forms of clubs. There's organizational clubs, and there's community clubs. But since you are part of this, you can be part of this community club. That way, your projects and things also align with the purpose of the organization. And we want to encourage all of you. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. TM Ellie comes, I'd like to call on all volunteers to come up stage. All the volunteers here, please come up stage. Let's recognize your effort as well. All the volunteers, please. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Jalilu. And let me say, volunteers, PMI is run by volunteers globally. And volunteers are not people born from a different planet. Volunteers are you and I who have decided to give a portion of our time to doing things for humanity without asking for money, especially in return. And PMI is not able to pay the teaming volunteers all over the world because volunteers are priceless. PMI cannot pay us, no. I went for an interview for VP membership. The interview was done in the room where we went to eat. And there are some chairs arranged at the top. I saw one of us sitting there eating. That was where I sat. And at the interview, I was asked, how many hours can you dedicate to volunteering in a day? I didn't understand. So I asked, how does it work? They said, oh, maybe 2 hours. I said, okay, I can dedicate 2 hours every day. They said, okay. Today, I think the question should have been, how many hours can you have for yourself when you decide to volunteer? But when the going gets tough, volunteers look at what to sacrifice when you have conflicting demands from your normal job, your life, your spouse, your children, your friends, and the chapter. It's very easy to sacrifice one. But we think of the members who have put their trust in us, then we have to trade off certain things. Ola is the branch chair for Takoradi. So he came from Takoradi. He bears his transportation expenses himself. When you hear in any meeting, Ola here, or this is Ola, in a book club meeting anywhere, indeed, this is Ola. We have Mr. Jalilu Isaaku, our VP membership. Membership. Membership is the bloodline, for that matter, the lifeline of the chapter. Apart from the fact that we look at the number of members we have, that is the main source of income for the chapter. The $35, if we should tell you how much we are spending per head here, you are finished consuming your $35. But the value you will gain is much more important to us than the $35. And he is the vice president in charge of membership. It is close, the portfolio is very close to my heart because that is where I came from to become the president. And he has been trying to shave clean, but the gray is there. It will gray you. And he's reaping the benefits. In fact, the portfolio is the largest. It oversees all branches as well as growing the membership and providing value for members. It is funny, if you focus on going out to look for more members, by the time you came, those you left would have left. Are you getting the point? Their membership would have expired and you would have lost them because you went out looking for others. So you should be going to look, coming back to check, feeding, providing value so that they will stay. It's a difficult situation. So we need volunteers to support. There are some vacant roles in the portfolio. And I believe, having heard what you've heard here today, you'll be forthcoming so we can all support the chapter to grow. Great. Then we have Manuela. We have two Manuelas in the leadership. This is Manuela with one L. And VP Professional Development, she is not here. She is Manuela with two L. That's the easiest way for me to identify them. She is the office manager for our office. If you have time, pass by the office at the fifth floor of Golf House. She'll be there to receive you. She is very meticulous. She may assist you spell your name better. Then, my good friend, we'll meet on the other side. TM Ellie. Ellie has been a volunteer for a long time. There was a time, I think you were webmaster? Editor for the PM Hub. Good. Before taking up the Toastmasters Club presidency. In fact, we are keen on Toastmasters because the project manager's role, about 90% of your time you are communicating, including fighting. Yeah, fighting is a communication, isn't it? Yeah. Sending emails, attending status meetings, it's all about communication. And communication alone can ruin your project. That is why we are keen on it. Don't be so quick to convert the $60 to Ghana cedis. Don't be so quick. Okay, that will scare you. Look at the value. You know, those who presented here, you saw the differences. I know someone, if you tell her to give the vote of thanks here now, will remain here till next year. And that is something you can easily kill. In 2021, there was a lady called Otima Irenchi. She was one of the global staff for PMI. She spoke at a conference, and after the conference, I approached her and said, how do you do it? She said, Frank, you can do it. You can. I said, no. When I stand in front, my knee, the left one especially, it shakes. She said, no, we all have it. But there are strategies for dealing with it. I said, how do you do it? She said, do you see Barack Obama sometimes trotting to the stage? I said, yes. Said, that's a way of calming yourself down. I said, how? Then I started following some of the world great speakers. All these Toastmasters can do the trick. Great. That's TM Ellie. Then Mr. Joseph Popolampo, one of the longest serving volunteers, if not the longest, here. As a new member, we went to Tema, and I gave him a lift in my car. Then we started talking about volunteering. Then he told me he's with membership and all that. Before I even thought of becoming a volunteer, he was already a volunteer. And when your membership is about to expire, you receive an email. When you renew, you receive an email acknowledging. When your PDUs are not enough for you to renew and your certification is about to expire, you receive an email. Better call him Pope. That is Mr. Pupulampo. So, you have taken the first step by becoming a member. It is just the first step. Take advantage of all the opportunities that are presented to you. And before I sit, let me say a big thank you to our Toastmasters team. I know you might have counted my arms and abs and soul and in fact, sometimes those ones are even better. Some people, they will go blank and stand there and look at it. I know one guy, he actually cried. when nothing was coming, he cried. So please take it seriously and work on it and let's all network and become better individuals than we met here today. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you very much. So I think the last thing we'll do is to take a closing prayer from a member of the winning team, as we earlier advertised. So those who did not present, you would say the closing prayer. We are being fair, Abby. Yes. So a member from the winning team that wasn't too much into the presentation, please come and say a closing prayer so that we go. And then we'll go downstairs and take our photographs. So we will take it in our groups with the volunteers, and then we'll take it as a community as well. We'll post all those on the PM Hub magazine that we'll be publishing. Closing prayer, please. Thank you. Round of applause.
Let's share a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you for bringing us together in fellowship and to share meaningful connections and relationships today. We thank you for a time well spent, and we pray that even as we leave here, you help us to continue to build on the meaningful connections that we've built today. We pray that even as we go, you grant us safe traveling mercies. You take us to our destination safely. This and many others we thank you for. In Jesus' mighty name, amen.
Thank you very much. We still have the souvenirs outside. Please make sure you grab one. There are t-shirts, there are mugs, there's the chapter cloth, key holders, pens. Make sure you grab some and then you can share with your friends. Thank you very much for coming. And then we'll still continue the chat on the platform. Thank you.